heartily salute brothers and sisters in Christ. I wanted to speak on this and say two things before I go live. That way I don't forget it, because they're very important. Last night, as I was heading home, or it might have been the night before, but it's not important. I was traveling and down the old familiar pathway, going down the back road, and a possum veered out in front of me, and I did all I could to avoid that possum. I went right, it went right. I went left, it went left. I slowed down, I smashed the brakes, but anyway, I could not avoid this possum. And lo and behold, I ran it over. And as I carried on down the highway, I felt a little terrible. You know, I didn't want to try to avoid it. I couldn't kill myself over it. I wasn't going to end up in the ditch or the field or a tree because of it. But I tried my best to avoid it, but the Lord said it was for a reason. And he spoke and he told me that the possum is dead. And I said, yes, I know, Lord. And he began to tell me about the possum and what it does. It ventures around, it goes to and fro, back and forth, in and out of, you know, things it shouldn't, you know, unseemly things, and it eats it. Well, he was speaking of a spiritual thing in my life that hinder things, you know, things that hinder, people might hinder, or whatever have you. But he was saying that he was going to put it to rest. He was going to lay it aside, that I was going to move on, that these things were going to be conquered once and for all. And so when the Lord speaks, it's a prophetic utterance to me. And I wanted to share it with you, that if you have a person or something, or something likened to a possum that goes back and forth, that might speak evil of you or whatever have you, the Lord says that the possum is dead. He's going to lay it to rest. He's going to put it to rest. I hope this helps somebody as well as it helped me to come at peace with running over the possum, conquering the possum, and putting the possum under the tire. Amen. So these are the words of the Lord to me, and he gives it to me so that I can share it. Another final thing, a secondary prophetic utterance. The Lord says that he should be glorified, and not just glorified, but also magnified. Not just glorified, but magnified from beyond what he has given us, the words he has given us. So when we go to the Bible, he adds to and magnifies himself. Like if you're looking under a magnifying glass, the closer you get, the broader the words get. Amen. So these are two prophetic utterances and prophecies this morning coming into this afternoon. I'll be going live soon. Holy salute to the Holy Club. If you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, now is the acceptable time for you. If you know him, keep him and get him closer and closer to your heart. Draw closer and closer to him. If you draw nigh to him, he'll draw nigh to you also. Be encouraged. Keep looking up. The time is at hand. The Lord is soon to come. Holy salute to the Holy Club. The possum has been put to rest. Bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.